is presented by Lawrence Technological University. Possible is everything. Sarah Chevrolet, the low payment people. Hungry Howie's Dough Raiser, your next fundraiser comes with flavored crust. Diversified Members Credit Union, proud to support Michigan youth sports because we believe in you. And SnethCamp Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Come visit Telegraph Road's newest Dodge and Ram truck dealer serving Detroit.
Hi, and welcome back inside the State Champs Sports Network studios. It's time for another edition of State Champs. We're presented by Lawrence Technological University. Possible is everything. I'm Kiera Lancaster.
Hey, Kiera, I'm Lauren Plant, and we've got a great show for you this week, among other things. A story that affects so many programs across the state, and that's being a part of a unified team. I mean, these are the schools you love to beat. Now you're rooting for each other. It does work, and we'll show you.
Hockey, swimming, wrestling, and cheer, it's all coming up. But first, it's the triple-double.
What is up, State Champs fans? Jerry Mack here. Let's tip this party off with the triple-double, shall we? Checking in first at Clarkston High School as the Wolves played host to the Zebras of Wayne Memorial. These two teams came out ripping. Rashad Williams kicks it out to Travez Nix. Nix from the corner, three ball, all tied up at 16 after one. Second quarter, Clarkston with possession. Wolves entered this contest unbeaten at 13-0. Wolves moving the ball around. Foster Lawyer with the alley. That's the 6'5 senior Dylan Alderson on the oop. Clarkston led by four at the half. Move along to the fourth, these two teams still battling. The senior, Keon Epps, with the highlight of his own. Epps with his hands in the cookie jar, but he won't get caught. The senior, throw it down. Memorial down just one. But moments later, the Wolves would answer. We've been watching this kid ever since he was a freshman. Lawyer, ISO on the wing, elevates and knocks it down. Cold-blooded Lawyer with a cool 40 on the night as the Wolves stay unbeaten, knocking off Wayne Memorial by a final of 73-68. Next up, we head over to Detroit Country Day High School for a matchup between the Yellow Jackets and the River Rats of Ann Arbor Huron. First quarter action, Country Day raced out to an 8-0 lead, but Huron would fight their way back in. Danny DeGiovine with the steal, and the junior would take it all the way. Huron trailed just 3 after 1. Early second quarter, Yellow Jackets begin to extend their lead. Great ball movement here in the feed down low to Tyler Bennett. The 6'4 senior beats the double team with the left-handed hook. Bennett would finish with 14 on the night. Still in the second, Country Day turning up the heat on D. That's Kayla Webb with the strip. Jasmine Powell ahead to Destiny Pitts, the senior with the finish, and one. Country Day up 6 at the half. Third quarter, Yellow Jackets starting to run away with this one. The sophomore Jasmine Powell couldn't be stopped. Powell going coast to coast for the bucket. All Country Day in this one as the Yellow Jackets win by a final of 53-35. Back to Lauren.
To Grand Rapids now, and I have no idea what was just said, but I do know Grand Rapids Christian is undefeated as they welcomed the visiting Wayland Wildcats on Tuesday. Wayland came in 11-2 overall, sitting just a game behind the Eagles for tops in the OK Gold. Wayland doing a good job early creating space. Nice dribble penetration by the senior guard Avery Hudson. Carter Nyup wide open from three-point country. He had 9 in the game. But the Eagles possess a Mr. Basketball candidate, and he made his presence felt. Three ball is too strong, but Xavier Tillman there with the rebound and the putback. Wayland came in winners of 7 in a row, had a response, kept hitting from the outside. This time Hudson doing the honors. It was a one-point ball game after the first, but Christian led 46-32 at the break. We've got the Eagles ranked second in the state in any class, and they dominated the second half. The fans went home talking about the big man Tillman, the future Spartan with a double-double, 12 points, 14 boards, 7 assists, 7 blocks, and this dunkaroo. Grand Rapids Christian beats Wayland Union 94-61.
The back-to-back Class C state champs from Beecher hosted unbeaten Flushing. The Bucks, coming off a loss over the weekend, they come out angry. Malik Ellison for 3. Couple of minutes later, it's Ellison to Jordan Rowland in the corner for another triple. That gives Beecher a 12-0 lead out of the gate. The Raiders played them even the rest of the half. Tyler Jamison with the backdoor cut for the score. The Bucks still up 31-19 at the half. Flushing then gets the big man going in the third. Joe Kuyat with the dream shake. He scored 19. And this isn't an instant replay. Kuyat gets him again, and the lead was down to 8. But they would get no closer. Ernest Sanders on the break. He puts on his jammies and says goodnight to the Raiders. Ellison led the way with 29. Beecher hands Flushing its first loss, 70-45. On the girls' side, huge matchup in Class C. Number 1, Sandusky at number 2, Reese. How important is this game? Check out Allie Blank hitting the floor for the loose ball. Gabby Guff eventually lays it in. Then at the end of the first, Jess Kurzinski beats the buzzer off the window for 3. The Rockets hanging tough though. They get it inside to Carly Selly, but in the end, number 1 beats number 2 to remain undefeated, 38-23. For state champs, I'm Ryan Slocum.
Hi, I'm Tom Markowski with another version of Fast Break, and this week we are pleased to introduce a new guest. This is Pat Donnelly, the head coach at UAD Jesuit, the defending Class A champions. Welcome to the show.
Thanks, Tom. Appreciate being here.
Well, I just want to say congratulations on last year's state title. Big win for the program.
Huge win for the program, for the school. 140-year history of UAD Jesuit. Excited to bring the first basketball state championship.
This year, high expectations as well. How has the season gone so far for you guys?
You know, it's gone well. We suffered 3 losses so far this year, which after going undefeated last year was a little bit of a pill to swallow. I'm happy with the progress. We feel like we've got a contender again this year.
Life without Cassius Winston, what's that been like? Last 4 years, he's really been really one of the top guards in the state, especially I felt from the freshman to sophomore years, last 3 years. What's it been like?
It's been tough because we were spoiled for the last 4 years. But at the same time, we've got a really talented point guard in Julian Dozier, who's now a sophomore, that has taken over the reins. Little different type of player, but he's done a phenomenal job so far this year. And now we're just enjoying watching Cassius play for Michigan State.
Talk about the Catholic League. I feel this is some of the best balance I've seen in the Catholic League. Catholic Central has already defeated your Cubs. Talk about the Catholic League playoffs and some of the, you know, what you have to look for there.
Yeah, so we have this week to finish the regular season, then the playoffs start a week from Saturday, and it's a very competitive league. They're very well coached. We match up with each other well, so it's going to be a very difficult process getting through the Catholic League playoffs.
Thanks for coming on the show, Pat.
Appreciate it.
Good luck in the state tournament. That's it for this week, and we'll talk more basketball next week.
We want to thank Coach Pat Donnelly for joining us this week on the Fast Break. We'll see if the Cubs can repeat as both the Catholic League and Class A state champs. We're just getting warmed up here on the original high school sports show. What's it like to be rivals and teammates at the same time? Stay with us.
I want to be a dermatologist, and though a lot of universities tried to recruit me for basketball, Lawrence Tech had the science curriculum that I wanted. LTU's Southfield campus is a great place to learn, and the classes are small enough that I don't have to wait for office hours to talk to my professors. They're usually right by my side, challenging me and guiding me toward a successful future. Lawrence Tech, possible is everything.
Okay, great. Thanks. Legal says we have to be crystal clear about the new loyalty program.
Seriously?
Seriously?
That will take the entire commercial.
Hold it right there, ad dudes. The new Howie Rewards loyalty program is now part of the Hungry Howie's app. Just spend $10 or more 6 different times, and you'll be in pizza heaven. A free medium 2-topping pizza just because you ate pizza? Now that's an idea. Download it today or sign up online.
Hungry Howie's!
At Diversified Members Credit Union, we serve the entire state of Michigan. With over 30,000 fee-free ATMs, we're with you wherever you go. To buy that new car, to take that dream vacation, to build that living room you've always wanted. Find out why so many people are choosing to own their own money by switching to a credit union. Apply today and become a member of the official credit union of the Detroit Lions. Visit us or click on dmcu.com.
Welcome back to State Champs. We've all seen how unified programs have helped school districts participate in particular sports. What started out as a struggle for the hockey team out in Kalamazoo is now working.
Rivals and teammates may seem like a recipe for disaster, but somehow the Kalamazoo United hockey team not only manages to get along, but Coach Tyler sees their structure as an advantage.
We're made up of three schools. It's Kalamazoo Loy Norix, Kalamazoo Central, and Hackett Catholic Prep. We're allowed to draw kids from all three schools. And yeah, the team dynamic's been really awesome. I think in some ways it's an advantage that the kids aren't together all day, and then they come to the rink and are seeing each other for the first time. And we do a lot of stuff off the ice to help build camaraderie and some of that team chemistry.
This hockey team is all about fun.
That's kind of been the motto all year, is to work hard, have fun, and we want to just keep trying to get better every day and see how good we can get at playing hockey.
We're unique in a way that we're like really laid back off the ice. We have a lot of fun in the locker room and hang out outside of the rink, but when we actually do step on the ice, it's all business.
Kalamazoo United is currently experiencing their most successful season in program history.
So far, we're having a really solid season. I think we're 18-1-1 at this point, which is more than I would have ever dreamed. The kids have worked really hard this year, and they've come together really well.
Starting off my freshman and sophomore year, we barely won any games. And last year, we finished 13-14. This year, we're 18-1, and we all push each other to win every day and think we can beat anybody.
Their game against the Kalamazoo Blade locked up their first ever regular season title with an ending score of 6-1.
This is my third year. I think my first year, and we only had 6 wins. So, and the kids have come a long ways in a short amount of time, in just a couple of years, and it's been a lot of fun.
For In Focus, I'm Kiera Lancaster.
Let's get the hat trick going with the top two teams in the MIHL South Division, Trenton at home to take on the Pilots from Warren D. LaSalle. Now with the state playoffs just a few weeks away, we're reminded Trenton has won the state championship 14 times, looking to get in the double-digit win category on the season. 27 seconds in, 2-on-1, Jack Palazzotto over to Drew Welsh, but the Pilots netminder Andrew Gruet with a huge save. We're scoreless after one, and it stayed that way through two and almost to the end of regulation. Under 3 minutes to go in the game, top 10 in the league in scoring is the Trojans' Jordan Cormier. 12 goals, 25 points coming in, tack on another. Trenton up 1-0. De La Salle up to 12th in our latest top 25, now competing in Division 3 in the playoffs. They pull their goalie for the extra attacker, and it works. The senior Matthew Pelto, 9th goal of the season, ties it up. So in overtime, the Trojans decided to give the hometown faithful what they came for, and in grand fashion. Just 3 seconds left, somehow the junior Cormier all alone, he buries it, and Trenton wins 2-1 the final. Next, we take a look at the defending Division II hockey state champs Romeo for a road Mac Red melee with Macomb Dakota. Romeo in red looking to sweep the season series. Sometimes you're just allowed to take a couple of whacks at things to get the desired result. The senior Mr. Hockey Kennedy Brett Lansky, his 22nd goal on the season, Bulldogs up 1-0. Dakota trying to move 4 games over 500. In the second, good puck movement. Kevin Maddox sees Andrew Brooks open at the back door, one of his 2 goals in the period. Cougars continue to press and kept throwing the puck at the net. I mentioned Maddox dropped a pair in the period. Here you go. Dakota led 3-2 into the third. Romeo would tie the game at 3, so Dakota looking to respond, leave it to a freshman. Knowing he's gonna get hit, Shane Rombach just shoots it through traffic. Back in the net, Dakota went on to beat Romeo 5-3, now within 2 points of the Red Division lead. Let's finish up with the madman, Jerry Mack.
Thanks, Lauren. Wrapping up the hat trick at the John Lindell Ice Arena, where the Berkeley Bears played host to the Farmington Hills Unified Flyers. These two teams played just a week ago. Berkeley came away with a 9-1 win then and looking to continue the trend now. The senior Josh Lichtman chasing the puck into the zone, off the boards to himself, wide open look, and Lichtman nets it to make it 1-0 Bears. On to the second period of play. Game tied at 1, Bears on the attack. Great job keeping the puck in the Flyer zone. That's Kevin Jervis over to Lichtman, and Lichtman snipes the corner for his 2nd goal of the game. 2-1 Bears. Just 2 short minutes later, Flyers on the breakout, Justin Bass all the way along the boards, centering pass finds Ben McCall, and the sophomore puts it home with the one-timer, all tied up at 2. It would stay that way until the third, Flyers forcing a couple of turnovers in the Bears zone, and this is McCall playing setup man this time, finds Carlos Tobar, who winds up and lets it rip stick side. And that would prove to be the game winner, as Farmington Hills Unified wins this round over Berkeley, 3-2 the final. For state champs, I'm Jerry Mack.
Sierra Chevrolet is proud to recognize the hardworking people in the communities they serve with the Sierra Chevrolet Community Awards. February's Athlete of the Month was given to Cole Bearden, a senior at Detroit Country Day. Cole has an outstanding GPA of 3.9 while taking all honors and AP classes. Cole is a three-sport athlete, playing football, basketball, and track. He is a Detroit Free Press first-team All-Stater in football. Cole has committed to Cornell University to play football in the Ivy League in the fall of 2017.
I'm just most looking forward to the bond that I'm going to make with my teammates. We've already started to get to know each other, and I can't wait to meet them in person and play with them.
Sierra Chevrolet is happy to award him as Athlete of the Month.
On behalf of Sierra Chevrolet, I would like to congratulate Cole Bearden on being the Athlete of the Month. Congratulations.
Thank you.
We've got big news regarding our first ever high school esports League of Legends tournament taking place at Lawrence Tech. We're waiving the $50 team registration fee. We need schools. There's great prizes, scholarship money, lunch, and just a whole lot of fun. So there's really no excuses. Join us by signing up your team of five at esportsmichigan.com right now.
Fundraising should be fresh, flavorful, and simple. We have the perfect solution at Hungry Howie's, Dough Raiser.
Probably one of the easiest fundraisers that I'm aware of. It's a logical fundraiser. Helps out with our costs for when we have to buy robot parts. Having the extra funds helped us be able to purchase those so we could have the parts for two robots. To me, it's a win-win.
Go to doughraiser.com to learn more and sign up. Welcome to Hungry Howie's Dough Raiser.
At Diversified Members Credit Union, we serve the entire state of Michigan. With over 30,000 fee-free ATMs, we're with you wherever you go. To buy that new car, to take that dream vacation, to build that living room you've always wanted. Find out why so many people are choosing to own their own money by switching to a credit union. Apply today and become a member of the official credit union of the Detroit Lions. Visit us or click on dmcu.com.
One esports tournament, 16 League of Legends teams, 80 high school students, 10,000 in scholarships, and limitless possibilities. All at the inaugural Esports Michigan High School Invitational, hosted by Lawrence Technological University's Game Art and Interaction Design Program. The registration deadline is February 13th, so sign your team up today at esportsmichigan.com.
At Sarah Chevrolet in Southfield, we know there are a lot of things competing for your attention these days.
So we make it easy to shop on your schedule with our extended hours. We're open until 9 p.m. Monday through Thursday and 24 hours a day at sarahchevrolet.com.
Sign and drive a Cruise LT for $77 a month, Trax LS only $64, or Equinox for just $68.
Plus up to $1,000 more for your trade.
Because at Sarah Chevrolet in Southfield, we make deals that get your attention. Hello? Hello?
February is Black History Month, and State Champs is celebrating some of the outstanding individuals who have made their mark and made a difference in high school sports here in the state of Michigan. This week is dedicated to Henry Washington. Henry was a three-sport athlete who graduated from Detroit Southeastern High School in 1975. He played baseball and basketball at Concordia University before transferring to Oakland University. During his time as a Golden Grizzly, he was the only African-American player on the squad. After earning his degree, Washington's real passion came from teaching and coaching. Collectively, Washington has coached 71 seasons. He was an athletic director for 14 years, including 6 years at his alma mater, Southeastern. After three-plus decades, Washington still enjoys his time in the classroom, currently involved with the Academic Engagement Program at Macomb Community College. State Champs salutes Henry Washington for his years and years of athletic and academic contributions into the lives of thousands of Michigan athletes.
We start the Blitz and Boys Swimming Mac White Conference matchup. Utica Eisenhower and the Macomb Lance Cruz North Crusaders going at it. To the grueling 500 freestyle, and these guys battling to the finish. I mean, this is neck and neck between North Stewart Nowinski and Ike's Anthony Gazzarato. Bottom of your screen, the junior Nowinski with the celly. He won by 5/10 of a second. But in the end, the Eagles of Utica Eisenhower would have both arms in the air, because in the backstroke, the senior Sean Scott could basically towel off by the time his opponents arrive. And Ike defeats Lance Cruz North, still out front of Frazier in the Mack White standings. Let's go to a D4 wrestling district finale in Lenawee County. Hudson taking on the Royals from Blissfield High School. Hudson, the top-ranked team in Division 4, looking to make the state finals for the ninth year in a row. We begin in the 125 weight class. The returning state champ, Jordan Hamdam versus Jacob Seville, and Hamdam with the Bam Bam. We're going in focus on Hudson next week, so stay tuned. In the meantime, they pulled off 8 pins in this effort at 145. Gavin Wagner in control of Blissfield's Matt Saylor. Hudson claims more D4 district hardware. And we stay on the mat for the Downriver League Cheer Championship. We start with the 3-time Division I state champs, the Titans of Southgate Anderson, here in the compulsory round. Anderson finished third. Next to the Jaguars of Allen Park, ranked 2nd in Division 2, they were rocking the house with this stunt round routine. But the Jags wound up runners-up. To the victor go the spoils. I give you Gibraltar Carlson, the reigning 6-time Division II state champs. The Marauders are once again Downriver champs. Let's take a moment now to look inside LTU Athletics. For the entire month of February, the American Cancer Society and Lawrence Tech are teaming up for the Coaches versus Cancer 3-Point Challenge. The men's and women's basketball teams squaring off to see who can raise the most money for cancer research through their game day performances.
It was a consolidated effort by both the men's and women's program as well as all the students on campus.
I think it's just a great thing, and it's a fun way for our parents and supporters and the community to get involved.
LTU wanted to take part as a way to raise awareness and support cancer education and encourage some friendly competition. Right now, the women's team way ahead of the game.
Well, it wouldn't surprise me right now. We're going to catch them in the end.
Right now, we're at $497, which has been awesome. It's a big jump for us, and it's fun to see, as we still have 4 more games in February, where we'll be at the end.
Hey, if you want to get involved and help your favorite Blue Devil basketball team win the 3-point challenge, go to LTUathletics.com. Then go to the men's or women's basketball page, and there you'll find the Coaches versus Cancer 3-point challenge.
Did you miss our latest Legend show featuring Jalen Rose? It's a story of the rise of Rose, and it has a lot of people talking. So be sure to check out the rebroadcast, and all those times are listed on your screen. The main event is next, and it's girls basketball. Don't touch that dial.
Lauren Plant here with the head coach of the new Lawrence Tech football program, Jeff Duvendek. You know, one of the advantages of starting a team from scratch is that he gets to hand select every one of the recruits that will suit up for the Blue Devils in the NAIA Fall 2018. He's signing players right now. Coach, tell the audience what kind of player you are looking for.
Well, first and foremost, we want guys that are academic fit for Lawrence Technological University. Second, we want competitors. We want guys that can compete not only on the field and practice in games, but in the weight room, in the classroom, everything that we're involved in, we're going to compete.
As many as 25 scholarships will be given out, and here's the easiest way for you to introduce yourself to Coach Duvendek. Go to LTUathletics.com, click sports. On the drop-down menu, click football, then click recruiting. Fill out the questionnaire and someone from the staff will get back to you. This is 2017. Recruit yourself and be a part of football history at LTUathletics.com.
SnapCamp is Metro Detroit's original Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram dealer, and we're still making the best deals every day.
Right now during Ram Truck Month, lease a Ram Crew Cab 4x4 as low as $189 a month, or a 2017 Jeep Grand Cherokee for just $269.
Sales service and a superior buying experience. That's SnapCamp on Telegraph Road in Redford.
SnapCamp, Metro Detroit's original. SnapCamp, SnapCamp.
Welcome back to State Champs. Hey, it's been far too long since we had girls basketball on the main event stage. So let's do this. We go to the KLAA. In fact, 2 schools playing their last year in the KLAA, Walled Lake Western at Waterford Kettering. C Senior Night Out at Waterford Kettering and four senior captains recognized under the Flower Tower during the pregame ceremony. After that, game time. Wall Lake Western beat Kettering by just a point earlier in the season, looking to remain on top of the KLAA North. Kettering and White has won this division 6 years in a row, not looking to stop the streak anytime soon. Ashley Watson missed a jumper, but the senior Lilia Schoaf cleans it up nicely. Captains up 10-2 after the opening quarter. Wald Lake Western came in 12-2, unbeaten in their last 10. In the second, Kaylee Ford kicks to Alyssa Murray. The senior knocks it down, so the Warriors down 9 at halftime.
We want to be aggressive on offense. We're playing to win. Do you understand that? Let's take advantage of the breakdown.
Let's go, ladies, right here.
Kettering maintaining its momentum to start the second half. The sophomore Watson on her way to 3 points the old-fashioned way. Now, Western only going to be in this thing if they could be consistent from outside. They struggled, but not here. The iron being kind to the junior Jordan Walchick. But the captain's 6-foot senior Schoaf is committed to Saginaw Valley, and she was playing well, including leading the way with a 9-point effort. Later, and on the break, Schoaf with the assist to the 6'1 sophomore Claire Bargan, who one-times it through the cylinder. Waterford Kettering takes it by a 34-22 final. They are back atop the KLAA North.
Today we were where we needed to be on defense, which made the difference from how we played the last time we played them and today. We were passing and catching a lot better on offense than we were the first game, and we were shutting down their three-point shooters, and I think that made the difference, and it feels great to get revenge.
That's all the time we have for this week's show. Make sure you join us each and every week at 9 a.m. right here on Fox Sports Detroit.
That's right. Beginning March 12th, people, it's the return of RoboZone. That's right. Highlights of the high school first robotics season. 7 weeks of the best robotics action following state champs every week at 9:30. The game is called Steamworks this year. It's going to be awesome.
Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.
State Champs is presented by Lawrence Technological University. Possible is everything. Sarah Chevrolet, the low payment people. Hungry Howie's Dough Raiser. Your next fundraiser comes with flavored crust. Diversified Members Credit Union. Proud to support Michigan youth sports because we believe in you. And Snap Camp Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Come visit Telegraph Road's newest Dodge and Ram truck dealer serving Detroit.